Yeah, so I just want to start by asking about the injury updates for this weekend.
Same. No players back from injury. No new injuries. So it's same situation.
You said about market, so I'll just get underway with that. Jedson Fernández, we know, signed on a loan deal this week. What can he bring, and can the fans expect to see him this weekend?
This weekend, they can expect him to be involved, starting or no, but for sure involved in the team. When you get players in January, normally it's because you need, and we need, because we lost important players for a long time, so we need this contribution. Young player, yes. Just arrived in a new country, yes, but at the same time has experience of playing for a big club, played already big matches, for example, Bayern Munich away for Champions League, Galatasaray away for Champions League, Europa League quarterfinals, so he's used to a high level of stress, of pressure, of responsibility. And he's a kid that can play in different positions in midfield, even wide on the right if we need. So we got him for his multi-functionality, and he's a kind of what I used to call a special loan, because it's not a 3 months loan and goodbye, is a 1.5 year loan where you will have time to develop, and who knows if he doesn't stay here for many years.
And the club has been linked to a number of strikers, Zeluis from Porto, Piontek from AC Milan, Fernando Llorente potentially coming back on loan. How vital is it that you get a striker in this window, and what kind of striker are you looking for?
These are three names out of 30. Lots of names are coming, and the majority of them, I think, are coming by players' entourage, agents, people that want to put names in the market. Do we need a striker? Yeah, if possible, yes. But has to be a positive situation for us. So in this moment we have these attacking players that, of course, they are very good. Son, Lucas, Lamela, Lo Celso, Dele Alli, of course, they are very good, but we miss that target man. So if it's possible, we are doing everything possible, and it's not easy, but we are trying to add that player to the squad.
I mean, is it possible to challenge for top four spot, progressing the FA Cup, progressing the Champions League, without bringing in a striker in Switzerland?
It's possible to play every match to win, even without a striker. We did that against Liverpool. We played to win. We tried to win. We did that against Middlesbrough. We are going to do that tomorrow. So with striker, without a striker, we are going always to try to win matches.
And Inter Milan say they are confident of signing Christian Eriksen this month.
Who?
Inter Milan.
Are they confident?
Apparently so, yeah. Are they right to be confident? How close is that move? We know Eriksen's agent is over in Milan at the moment.
If you have to ask the agent and Inter Milan, because they know more than me. If they are confident, is because they are ready to. They are ready to make us an offer, which didn't happen yet. So when I see people speaking, and especially people with responsibilities, speaking about it, I am a little bit surprised. That's the only thing I can say.
And do you think it's sad how Eriksen is leaving things for the fans?
No, because I think he's trying to do his best. And I think it's normal that until the 31st of January, his brain is not totally focused. I think it's a normal consequence of the situation. And if I am a player and I'm reading every day and probably I'm having informations about that optimism that you are speaking about, I think it's normal that the player doesn't know very well what is going on. But I still don't understand why that optimism, because in this moment, for a few matches, people is speaking about is going Eriksen to play. Eriksen played already his last match for the club, and the situation didn't change. Eriksen plays tomorrow.
Jose, I want to ask you about Lucas Moura. He ran tirelessly against Borough and I thought he did very well at the top.
Yeah, the problem is if the gasoline finish, that's the problem. I'm sorry to interrupt your question, but I understand what you say. He's playing fantastic, he's working incredible. He's playing every minute. In the last match, I just managed to give him a 30 minutes rest. Because in this moment, you know, I think he's living a very good moment. I think he's a great thing for a player to know that the coach likes him a lot. He knows that I tried to buy him to Real Madrid when he was still in Brazil. So I think the good feeling comes from many years ago. We have a good feeling. I think I'm bringing him to a certain level of confidence, of work rate, of commitment to the team, of responsibility, that with the talent that he always had, I think he's in a very, very good level. But again, in this moment, no rotation. In this moment, it's just play, play, play. So I hope gasoline doesn't end.
Could we see Son Heung-min playing that striker role if needed?
Yeah.
And as far as Tanguy Ndombele is concerned, I just wanted to ask, is he frustrated that he hasn't been able to provide his full fitness yet?
Is he frustrated? You have to ask him. Am I frustrated or is he frustrated?
More him.
I don't know. You have to ask him.
And as far as Watford are concerned, they've been brilliant recently under Nigel Pearson. I suppose it's been tricky planning that game.
I think it's always tricky, Watford. I always felt, every time I go to Watford, I always felt difficult matches to play. Great atmosphere, great support. They are very adapted to that style of play. They have the right players to play the way they want to play. There is no way to run away from that, because that's the style they impose in their game. And of course, very good results. Lots of people at a certain moment they thought they were really in trouble in the table. And now, after a few months, they are in a very good position and getting fantastic results. So very difficult.
Jose, I see that Hugo Lloris is back in first team training. So when can we see him back out on the pitch?
I told February. So the normal thing is February. If you ask me late February, early February, I go more for early. Things are going well. He's getting his confidence back, his training. So I would say he's one of our new players in the January transfer window.
Jenson Fernandez, I see that his family are already in London. How crucial could that be for the transition for him, a young man coming to London and trying to take on the Premier League?
I think it helps. The fact that he speaks fluent English is good for interaction, for everything. The family living here, I think, is an amazing coincidence. For a few years, he doesn't live with parents and sisters, and because of his football career, and now his football career that brings him to the family again. So I think he can only be happy and enjoy the happiness of the family, and it looks like they can walk to the stadium because he's really, really close to the stadium. So I think it's a fantastic coincidence, and I'm pretty sure that will help him, yeah.
Just finally for me, in terms of players you've managed in the Premier League, who does Edson Fernandez most, who's he most similar to in terms of players you've managed?
Wow, that's a difficult one. I have no time to think about that. I have no time to think about it. I don't know. Give me, maybe I can answer you in the next press conference next week. I need to think about it.
Okay, go to Jonathan today.
Jose, are you any close to agreeing a new contract with Jan Tongan?
With?
Jan Tongan.
If you are close, I don't know.
Is it still an issue with his agent?
No. I told him in the beginning of my period when I arrived. We had three players in situation of handing contract, and the one that was easy to resolve was the one where everybody had no doubts about what they want for the future. Everybody wanted the same. The player, the agent, the coach, we club, everybody wanted the same. So that one was an easy one. Let's see what happens.
Hi, Joseph. Mauricio Pochettino was in London this week for the launch of La Liga TV. When you got the job, you said...
What's that, Liga TV?
I think it's like the TV channel of La Liga.
Yeah? So you can watch La Liga in that channel?
Yeah, I think so. I believe so, yeah.
Yeah? That's good.
You said when you got the job, you wanted to wait a month or a few weeks and then try and speak to Mauricio. I wondered, have you had that chance to speak to him since you took the job?
I'm too busy. And he's enjoying his period. He's enjoying his country. I think it would be very, very easy if one day he comes here. His son is here with us. This is his club. The doors are open. Anytime he wants to come to visit everyone, it would be a wonderful opportunity.
Jose, you said a couple of weeks back that Spurs would be reactive in the transfer window, kind of replacing players that might have gone. If Christian does leave the club, would you look to bring another playmaker?
But again, the Christian situation is your situation in this moment. Yours and I think Inter. Because if you have people with responsibilities speaking about it, it's because he's also their situation. In this moment, it's not my situation. He's selected for tomorrow. It's nothing new, I'm sorry, to say about Christian. Tomorrow he's selected for the game.
To ask you about a player who is at the club, Giovanni Lo Celso, you've been very happy with him in recent games. How's his kind of body reacted after his first, I think it was 90 minutes? He looked a bit like he was struggling towards the end as well.
Yeah, he was. 90 minutes of incredible work, raising his levels in relation to intensity of the game and work with, without the ball. Incredible. Amazing kid, quiet, working, waiting for his opportunities. Opportunities are coming step by step. Very, very happy with him. But yesterday, yes, a little bit tired, and that's normal. But I cannot give him a rest. He has to be has to be ready for tomorrow, because again, in this moment, to make selection for the squad for every match is being very, very easy, because we have basically these numbers available now.
Just one final one from me. You've obviously been desperate to look for time with this squad without any interruptions of matches, things like that, properly work with them in training. With the break that hopefully you'll get a long period if there's not a replay, are you looking to take the team away for like a warm weather training camp?
No. The players are going to have a little bit of time, which they need, which deserve. And after that, we are going to work here. And that will be an important period for us, because it's before Champions League and it's before this last part of the championship. But we are not going to go away. To have better facilities than we have is impossible. We cannot find that anywhere. And we just hope the weather is okay. Not phenomenal, but okay. And if that's the case, we have fantastic conditions to work. We can even decide to stay in here and sleep here and stay here together for a couple of days. We can obviously do that, and we probably will do it.
Thanks for Charlie.
Just on the sell side, do you think a permanent deal will be done this month or end of the season? Do you think a permanent deal will be struck for the Celso either this month or at the end of the season?
I imagine yes. I think it's something that comes from the summer. And there are some loans that they have the objective, or they have the opportunity for the club to be in control of the situation, like is happening now with Jetson. So, you know, there are some emergency loans and there are other loans that the objective is to be in control of the future of the player without any need of further negotiations. So I think Giovanni is going to stay with us.